you can tell us something about the work you do with rice, and also later maybe also some work the way you try to relate to the farmers. So you said that the farmers near in the vicinity, they do not really follow your way, but then your foundation, as far as we know, also try to approach different farmer communities and help them through technicians and helping with technicians. So maybe you can briefly tell us about this.
I will start with my younghood, because my family own a lot of land, the rice land, paddy land. So I live among the farmer family that use our land and work on our land. So I see from my younghood that how the farmer grow rice the old way. Because the technique of growing rice just start 40 years ago in Thailand, 40 years ago. Before that, they grow rice like 100 years ago, never changed. So I see the old way of growing rice until I left my family to study. I come back. When I come back, I bring the technique, the new technique in growing rice together to my hometown. It start when I graduate the new technique of growing rice in my area. So I can see what the change and what effect the effect of the new technique to the farmer and to the environment. So I see all the way, the old transition to the new. And the first, it look good, it's like a better yield and better profit. Everything seemed good until 10 years passed, something is not good anymore. And until now, it's worse. So I see clearly what happened. So because I'm not study in agronomy, but I study in animal science. I don't work with the rice when I graduate. I'm working with the animal. But I see my neighbor around growing rice. But I don't interest in that, because I interest only in my business. Until I became the monk and changed my mind and want to help the people. And after I working with the NGO for 5 years in the Northeast with the rice farmer, but teaching them how to grow raising fish in the rice field. The fish is my expertise that time. And I decided to go back to my hometown to help the people. So I decided to working with the rice farmer, because most of the farmer in Suphanburi is a rice farmer and they're very poor. And I want to pay back my debt with the rice farmer. So I decided to working with the rice farmer. But I have no knowledge or expertise about rice, because I don't practice anymore or before, and not study in rice. That may be the weak point, but I found that it's a strong point. Because if I study in the rice and economy, I will stuck in the technique that they teach me. Because I don't know, so I free from them. I start with blank, with zero, not minus. Because if you study, you minus, you stuck with the chemical. Because I don't study, so I start with nothing, with zero. It's lucky. So I studied from the clever rice farmer who still use the old practice, like in the Northeast, that I found some of them in the 5 years that I worked in the Northeast. I studied from them, and they're really clever because they use the local wisdom and the Buddhist philosophy connect with the technique. So from that, I learned more from our friend in the foreign country, the West, and our neighborhood nearby. So all of them, we try to make the new technique. And I'm lucky that Mother Rice gave me the technique that I don't know in that time. Like in fusion, everything we test them, we never believe anything, but we test them in our land until it works. So after they work, we select the farmer who want to join us, only one or two only. I guarantee that if our technique is failed, we will pay them. They never lease anymore. So we test with some farmer until that farmer became the best farmer of Thailand 5 years later. So we think that because we have the success farmer, after that it's very easy, because we think that the farmer looking for the best, if they have the good example, they will follow easily. This is our thinking in that time. So our policy is make the good farmer some place, the best farmer, and from that the neighborhood will learn from them and copy and following. It's easy. Learn from the farmer themselves is better than learning from us. But it's not like that. After 20 years, nothing happened. Because even the farmer is success, even we stay here, nobody follow. We don't understand for many years until we have the research why they don't follow the success story. Even it's better, even it's easier, even it's less labor, even it's more safe, everything's better, but nobody follow. We don't understand until we have the research and we found that because the farmer controlled by the paradigm or the program in their brain. Because the farmer is like a computer. They have two systems in the brain. The first is the hardware, is the brain that can remember the information. The same, the hardware is no problem. They have the good brain, but the software is the problem. The software control the hardware to working, because they must have the software. The software of the farmer controlled by the big company. They just send the information to the advertising and through the policy of the government to the education, college, university, controlled by the big company. They're promoting the hygiene variety. They're promoting the chemical, the green revolution, the marketing economy. Everything just put on the brain of the farmer. In the paradigm or in the program. So this is the problem, because when the farmer have this program, they refuse our technique, because our technique don't use any chemical. So when we show that we success, they cannot follow. They just said, this is very good, I know, but I cannot follow. I ask why you cannot follow, because it's easy and it's work and everything is better. They said, because I cannot make up my mind to stop using chemical. I cannot make up my mind. I want, but I cannot. So I understand, because the paradigm or the program control they cannot change the program. So only one way, you must change the program in the brain of the farmer before they can adopt our technique, our success story. Only one way to change the program. And in Thailand, the success story about changing program is the secret. So in secret in Thailand, we change the program in the head of the people. In the past, when I'm the student, everybody must smoke. The man must smoke to be the man. Drink and smoke is the sign of the cowboy, the man. I cannot because I'm allergic. So I'm upset because I want to smoke and I want to drink, but I cannot. I'm allergic. I have the, what you call the, cannot breathe after I drink this allergy. So I'm upset, I want to smoke. Everybody smoke and drinking that time because the program of the smoking is very good. It's good sign of the man to smoke. But now in Thailand we change that paradigm because we stop advertising. You cannot advertise that smoking is good. And after that we increase the tax. It's very expensive. And we prohibit. You cannot stop. You cannot smoke here. You cannot smoke there. You cannot smoke. And more than that, they take the tax to put to the fund to promoting the what you call the disease from the smoking. What the, everything is very bad image about smoking. So in Thailand, we can control the smoking by changing the paradigm of the people. But we cannot do like this with the chemical, because the big company, they know already that if they let us do like this, they bankrupt. So even we can push this policy to the government, every government deny because the big company just lobby. The election government support by the big company, so we cannot change anything. So why the people just want to change by themselves before election? Because we try for more than three government, at least three government, and fail. So I think for the rice farmer technique, the best technique in this situation is to reduce the cost of production. You reduce the cost of production is the main, because you must competition in the world market. If you want to grow for sale, you must reduce your cost and increase your quality, the two of them. When you reduce the cost, you can sell in the low price, still have the profit. In high quality, you can sell in better price because the consumer will pay for you, like organic and the medicine rice. You can choose both. But if you grow for yourself, for your consumption, no matter, you can grow whatever. So for self-efficiency is a very good what you call policy for the small farmer. Grow for yourself first and just sell the left, what you call, the leftover that you cannot eat, you sell all the profit. Not just invest and grow and sell. If you sell in less than your invest, you are bankrupt. So the sufficiency economy from our king is the best solution. But 90% of the Thai people don't follow this because their program controlled by the what you call the market economy from the media. So the same, the good thing need the good programming and the program controlled by the media controlled by the big company. Everything is the problem. We must control the big company first, but the big company depend on the politics. So if we not succeed in politics, we cannot do anything for the better. So why the the people must be uprising first before our success will be followed by the majority. Now we have every sector, we have the good example already, like more than 30 years of the NGO and the people that make something good everywhere, but small cannot multiply. It's waiting for the wind. I think we need the wind to multiply the success story in Thailand. We work for a long time and we succeed, but cannot multiply to the majority, to the people. But they block by putting the bad program to the people. So the program control them like a robot. So this very short story. The technique is the easy because our technique not come from the West, not come from the text. It come from the practice, from the what you call experience of many people, success story, and from the nature directly, from other rice that teach us. And we not believe anybody. We just test them before we adopt any technique. Just test them. So the Dhamma that the Buddha teach us come from the nature. So my master tell me that the Dhamma is the nature themselves. So all nature is the Dhamma. So you can learn from them. And behind the nature, there are the law of nature. So the law of nature is the Dhamma. So you found the law of nature. So you just find out the Dhamma.
No nature.
The law of nature.
Law of nature.
The law of nature. So when we working with rice, so we just follow this. What is nature of the rice? What the law of nature behind the rice? So we not farm out ourselves. We test them. We just observation. We test, or we just take the knowledge from the Mother Earth, Mother Rice, and we test. After that, we adopt some technique that we prove that this works. And we test with the farmer. After 10, 20 years, okay, it's work. But every technique must be adapted to any location, not just exactly like formula, no formula. Everything is changed. And in changing, you must change everything, follow that. Because one principle of Buddhism is change, everything is changed. So you must change all the time. So from changing, you have the suffering, because if you don't accept the change, you're suffering. You cannot stop changing. And the last principle is emptiness. Everything is nothing, it's changeable. No matter, no energy, everything is changeable. So nothing is exactly, nothingness in Buddhism, not meaning nothing. There are something but not exactly, they can change. So it's like emptiness. So don't fix to anything because everything is it not themselves, it can change. It may be complicated, but this is real. So from this view, we can work with the farmer and with the rice. We can accept everything. And we believe in change because the principle of breathing is changed. So now the rice farmer is falling down until it's worse. And we think that if always change, they will change and change. When they are bottom, when they change, they must up. no more. Because most bottom, most down, and the new change is more up. Like a circle. They up and down, now and down, they up again. So this circle is nature. Like the literature in the Chinese, the three group, what you call the three empire, no? You know, the three empire is a learning book when I'm young. in Thailand, we translating for more than 100 years this literature, and all of the students learn this literature, the Three Empire in China. And beginning of the literature, they said the empire is sometimes up, and after that it's falling down, and after falling down, they up again. This is the beginning of that literature, I remember, the same. So, I think this is the same Buddhist and Tao, yeah, you can Tao. The same period. I think the Tao Te Ching and the Buddhism is beginning in the same period, and the same principle. I believe that it's the same. We can learn from each other. And I know that last 5 years, they found the tomb in China, 2000 year tomb. They found the oldest scripture of the Tao Te Ching, you know, in the Muang District or something, in the Han dynasty, no? They writing on the seal, no? Miracle. And that lady, there are one lady, they floating in the medicine water, and still fresh. And that mummy is a miracle, that lady. And the tomb of the son of that lady that have the literature, he collect the literature. I don't know that they translate or not all the literature, but Tao Te Ching they translate already to the English. The oldest, not only the problem of the technique, but problem of the suffering of the mankind. So some of my teacher, very famous, he's expert in the orchid, you know, the expert orchid in the world, Professor Lapi Sakrik, he's still alive, more than 90 years. He told me that he working with orchid, not for the orchid. Orchid is the way to go to the truth, to the Dhamma. So everybody can use anything to go to the Dhamma, because Dhamma is the nature. If you're working with rice, you can use rice to go to Dhamma. If you work with the orchid, orchid can bring you Dhamma. You work with the everything. Like the one mountain have only one top. You can go from this way, this way, this way to the top. Depend on you. What way fit to you is okay. But the last spot is the same, is the top of the mountain. You can go this way until you go to the top. You go this way. You can meet, became oneness in the top. But before that, you still different. You this side, you cannot see each other. You think that, oh, my way is the best way, is the correct way. You already wrong. No, every way is right, but you must go to the top until you found that, oh, everywhere come to the same spot, to the top of the mountain. I think every region is like the way, different way, but the last is the same spot. In Buddhist, we call Nirvana. In Christian, call God. Same. I think we call different name, but the spot is the same spot. If you go there, you can find that, oh, it's the same, but different word only. So after 30 years about working with the right farmer, I found that not the right is our destiny, not the farmer, but the Nirvana or the nature, the real nature of everything, not only human, but everything is the same nature. I think this is the conclusion. So I don't worry about my success or failure after working. Everybody have their own karma. They must pay back their own karma they make their own karma. So I cannot change them. I just teach them only. But I cannot change anybody. Everybody must change themselves. They have free will. Every mother have free will to choose to make karma themselves, to think, to talk, to action. Nobody can control. So when I do my work the best that I can, it's my duty, it's the finish. I cannot do more than this. But I must live possible for myself, for my destiny. First, that I must go to the top of the mountain. And this, I teach my student that when you learn from me, you not learn the rice growing technique like I learned from my mother. I want you to happiness, but the happiness is nothing. It's the suffering that less. So you must find out the suffering in your life and try to less your suffering until it's gone. That your duty, your land duty, is to make your happiness through the less suffering. And the cause suffering is easy in Buddhism. You greedy is the cause of suffering. So greedy is easy to control them. It's the most easy. If you greedy, you just pay, you just give, you not take. If you give it against the take is greedy, if give is against. So if you think that you're greedy, you just donate, you give to the poor or give to someone, not only money or material. Give your will, give your advice, give your smile, everything you can give. This is the way to stop your greedy. And the anger is the more difficult, jealous, competition, everything is anger. So the way to stop anger, the way of Buddhism is before you sleep in the night, you think about what you are angry most, the enemy, the people that you most hate, everything that you don't like, think of them and just bless them. Oh, this man is really bad. Let them happy. Let them succeed. Just pray for them against our head. So I want to see this man happiness and success. Even they hurt us, everything. You do this every night. So your head is less. And after that, easy to control. The Buddhist way to against the greed and against the hate, it is more easy. Easy than ignorance. Ignorance is the last that difficult. Because ignorance is the, you don't know the truth. You must find the truth. And you cannot find the truth because you are programmed in your brain. You must change your program by meditation, so you can see the truth by meditation to take off the program. Or I think that you can use the technique like a ayahuasca or some magic mushroom that controlled by the shaman that can take you out from that program. It's possible. Or floating in that. That's possible because this is a tool. But the tool is a tool. If you cannot use them properly, it's a danger. Everything have danger. Even the water, if you don't proper, you can choke. You can drown. The water is even the air. Everything have the benefit and the danger. You must proper manage them. So everything, even meditation. I know that someone is crazy after that because they see something and they think that it's true and they just follow it, think crazy. it's possible. You might what you call help the master to help you in beginning. When you became a monk and you try to meditate, the law of the Buddhism is you must have the advisor to advise you at least 2 years, because it's dangerous for you to meditate alone. You can see some picture and you panic or something. It's not true picture. It's a what you call? It's a hallucination. The same when you drink like a ayahuasca, you have hallucination. You must have the shaman or someone to advise you. It's the same. So if you want to know the technique, I think the technique is the easiest in working. But in working with the farmer, the rice farmer, how to change the mind is the most difficult. Flower that on the top of the water, it been bloomed in this day. This kind of people, they win enlightenment themselves without anybody help. They very, very progressive, but very few. This first class of the people, like the lotus flower that been bloomed this day. The second class is the lotus flower under the water, but very shallow, will be bloomed the next day. These people group, if they listen or see something is can teach them a little bit, they just enlightenment easy. But they need someone to advise them. The first, no need. But the second, they need someone to teach or advise. The third class of the people, like the lotus that deep in the water, half of bloom, half destroyed by some fish or some disease. So it's 50-50. They can enlightenment if they're lucky enough to find a good teacher, and they were trained a lot before they can enlightenment, but they can. But if they have no lucky, they cannot. It's the third part. The last is the lotus flower that never bloom because they are too weak and too deep, so it never. So this kind of people, nobody can teach. They must use many lifetime before they can learn. So they learn by themselves for many, so long time. So this kind of people, even the Buddha cannot teach. So in my experience, 30 years, I found that my student, the best student is the first class. Very few. Maybe they don't listen to me, but they can learn from anywhere and they can enlightenment, they can change by themselves easily. But very few, less than 1%. Second class, the student that come to us when we have the class and we ask for the fee, not free, they come. And this class easy to teach because they want to change, but they don't know how to change. But they must practice. This about less than 10%, about 6 or 5%. The third class is the most, about 60% of them is the third class that not come to us yet because they just controlled by the mass media, by the advertising. They don't come to us. But if there are no advertising, they can change like a cigarette. The majority is this class, the third class. The last that never enlightenment even have opportunity or the good master is, I think, less than 5% still, but very few. So now we succeed with the first and the second class. But the third class, the majority, more than 60%, we waiting for the win, waiting for the good constitution, good government, and good media. That we try to go to this. And we hope that this year, the beginning of the win. But we wait for a long time for the majority to follow our technique and our success, but they controlled by the media. So that factor is stronger than us, so they go to that. If we are stronger, they come to us. So this third class, I think, is majority of the farmer in the world.
Maybe you can later tell us also the scale of organic farming, because now it's not only farmers that do it, it's mostly corporations.
Mm-hmm.
Big companies now go into organic farming.
Yeah.
So,
but
so
in Thailand, very really few.
Yeah. So Thailand, very few. And the other question is, you are also trying to breed different seeds in order to save seeds. Yes. Could you tell us something about that?
Organic farming in Thailand, less than 1% of the area. Less than 1%, because we have the number, because we have the organic certificate office, and we know how much they really organic. So very few, even the market is big, but the farmer don't come to this market because the brand control is a very strange. Because in Thailand, the Ministry of Commerce, they analyze the market, world market, and they know that, oh, the organic product is a grow very fast, 20% per year, very fast. But the need is a lot, but it's no product, no production. So they try to promoting organic farming in Thailand by Ministry of Commerce, but the Ministry of Agriculture, no, they don't promote at all because they controlled by the big company. So it's strange that in the marketing, oh, organic farming is very bright, but the farmer, if they just follow the market, they just go to organic market. But no, they just growing for the low market, cheap market, and high input, and they have no profit. It's very strange. Even they know that it's no profit, they're still working because they cannot change. And they cannot change because they cannot make up their mind. They said.
But is it also because organic farming requires more labor?
It's no, our technique proved that less labor. We not spray, we not use any chemical, we not plowing. It's very, very low labor. Very low. You can lazy. But they said, I cannot make up my mind. I said, not burn the straw, rice straw, not burn them. They said, no, I cannot make up my mind. Don't put the fertilizer. No, I cannot. Don't spray, no. If you not believe, just take small piece of land to prove, this piece of land, you use our technique. And if not work, I can pay for you. If not it work, you can multiply by yourself. No, they not prove with us. Even we can see that we can pay for this. They no. Because even small piece, if they not put fertilizer and the chemical, they cannot sleep. Because the brain is the control. It's like a robot. It's programming. It's very, very serious. It's like a joke but not joke. They said it's more easy that I can change my religion than I can stop using chemical. We can change the religion, it's more easy than stop chemical. It's real. Because now they change already. They have nothing to be the Buddhist. I asked them what Buddha says. The first thing is not kill. No kill. They kill every day. when they spray the queue, they know. They see the snail they kill, they see the insect they kill, they see the rat they kill everything. They are no Buddhists anymore. Even if we have the technique that no kill, they said no. Because this technique not use chemical, we must use chemical. And the Buddhist said, you must help yourself. Nobody can help you, you can help yourself. But now they ask to the government to help me. Please help me. Company help me. Don't depend on themselves. They depend on someone. It's not the teaching of the Buddha. They cannot be the Buddhism. So it means that from this program, they wash away all the good things from the farmer. In the past, the farmer just very good person. When we grow rice, the first, in the past, we just direct seeding. The first direct seeding, they put the grain, the seed, and throw. Before throw, we just praying that from this yield, from this harvest, we give this to the nature. So the second one, give this to the creature that very poor, they cannot harvest, they cannot grow, so like anyone, let them eat. So they pray for this. This for the monk who cannot plowing, so I give to the monk. So the fourth for myself. So everything they have the kindness before they do everything. It's not selfish anymore. But the farmer now, they don't give anybody. They just for sale. One for sale, second for sale, for sale. So they change a lot after they adopt the Green Revolution. Because the Green Revolution did not come alone with the technique, but they come with the paradigm, with the program that, oh, this could grow for sale only, not for anything, for the profit, for richness, not for anything. So they change the paradigm, not change the technique only. Technique just support the paradigm, support the program only. So when the government promoting the Green Revolution, they come from the first plan of the development in Thailand in 1961 is the first plan. The first plan writing by the World Bank, they controlled by the US, and the first plan, they promoting the exporting. And the government in that time have the motto that the work is money. The money is work that can make you happy. The money can make you happy. So our master, Buddha Bhikkhu, the first person who against this motto, he said, no, this is not Buddhist. This is very bad. If you bring the money and happiness together, it's the worst. It's bad, not the Buddhist. It's not true. So the government very angry. They said, this monk is communist. It's a bad monk. So it's a big issue. So, you know, until 30 years later, when I'm became a monkhood with this monk, everybody that enter that temple, the police must bring the history where he come from, his family, what he do. He think that the monk who go there is communist. Even me, they just think that who that not agree with this motto is a communist.
What's the name of the monk?
The Buddha Bhikkhu. Buddha. Buddha is a Buddha. That is the slave. He is slave of the Buddha. His name means the slave Buddha. Bhikkhu is a monk. Buddha Dad Bhikkhu. The slave of the monk, the slave of the Buddha. He put his name because he worked for the Buddha like a slave to spread the word, the Dhamma. So he's the first that against the development. He said development it was not totally developed, only the material. So we will go to the suffering. He predict from that time, 1961, and now it's true. Because we need only money, only profit, only the material. So we more and more suffering. What happened? Oh, the cat together. The fight. Give it that man. I fight. The cat fighting. And the dog chasing.
But then that means within the, among the monks there would be the force, at least for example this monk, he would be teaching against development.
Yeah.
But that would be a small, very minority among the monks.
Minority. Less than 1%. Because all the monk now is programming the same like a human. They don't monk anymore. They became monk because they have the income or have the something that good for them. It's career, yeah. It's not the monk anymore. So why I deny to be the monk? Because I see the monk like this everywhere. So I'm and more monk than them now. I eat 2 meals, but most of the monk eat 3 meals.
And a lot of meat here.
Yeah. They don't monk anymore. They have more money than me. They have the car. They have the everything that has more suffering than me. So why I lucky that I can find the best monk in Thailand, because I want to give my money to my mother. So I sought out the best monk. So this connection from my love of my mother. So I want to pay back to my mother. So the best that my mother wanted to be, I'm a Christian monk, and I became a monk because of my mother. And I find out the best master because to be the best monk. And from the best monk that I changed my life. Everything is connection. It's karma, it's connect, but beginning from my mother, not me.
Hey Cha, 8 years ago when we came, you took us to some of the farmers nearby, I think, and they learned from you and they use your method, you know, and are they still working?
Yeah, they're millionaire. My first student that follow us 19 years ago. Uh-huh. 19 years ago, he became the best farmer in Thailand, 19 years ago. And now he's a millionaire. Because from 20 life, they have beginning, they have 20 life of land. And he learned from the landlord to be 90 life, to enough for their living. Small piece, not enough. So after they follow our technique, now he have 150 rice. He buy 90 rice more. And one rice is about 100,000 baht. So it means that he used 9 million baht to buy the land. The profit more than 9 million baht. In 19 years, but not only land, he have the truck, he have the pickup, He had the money left in the bank. Two daughter and one son, graduate master degree, not bachelor, but master. So everything is based for the rice farmer, but nobody follow him. The neighborhood or his cousin, nobody follow him. But the student come from all Thailand come to him because he spread in the tradition, and everybody know. And all the, every day they come, you can visit and you can see they have the guests every day. Go to his home to study with him. Now he growing rice now. The first season, they can grow 2 seasons. The first season is starting now because the flood is gone and he's starting after flood. 2 seasons and the flood is coming. So easy for him to get 1,000,000 baht per year, it's easy. At least the profit, the lien profit, the net profit is more than 1,000,000 baht per year from 2 seasons. And when the government have the what you call the supporting program, the profit increased to two million. Too much, is it? Because the cost production is very low, less than 3,000 baht per ton. Less than 3,000 baht. So a lot of profit. And he worked really easy because in 115 rice, he worked only 2 persons, he and his wife only, and have the free time. But they use our technique, it's very simple. Everybody know that he succeeded, but nobody follow. This is very bad. The government, if they want to help the farmer easily, just promoting like him, pay nothing. Don't waste any money or any time. But this technique is regulated for the big company. They cannot say anything. The farmer can do themselves everything. The seed, the fertilizer, the spray or the machine, the farmer can do themselves 90%. Only the fuel, that's not much that they can buy. The machine, the small machine that they can buy, but they can repair themselves. Another tool they can make themselves. Very simple. So this kind of the technique help a lot. The farmer can solve the problem. But the company and the government don't like it because it free the farmer. And the farmer can be decided by themselves. They cannot control the farmer anymore. So the bad government cannot exist. They cannot buy the vote. So this against the politics. Everything is good is against the big company and the politics. So where the big company have power, the good government cannot happen. Except the people is strong enough to come like us. But it's difficult, not easy. I think even in the US, they controlled by the big company. The Democrat and Republican, the same. Someone said to me, like a Coke and Pepsi, the same. One party is Coke, one Pepsi, you can choose. In Thailand now, it's almost like that. One is a Phua Thai, Thaksin, one is a Democrat. Same, not different, the same. When the Democrat became the government, I try to approach the same. not different. So why we need the reform? Even the leader of the reform come from Democrat, but not Democrat anymore because the people don't accept him because he Democrat. except because he resigned from the Democrat Party. And the policy not come from him. The people behind him a lot. He just spokesman only, not the leader, the spokesman.
But Daycha, do you still have your technicians go to the farmer communities and help them?
Not yet. We training here.
Now you do the training here.
Yeah, because we found that if we go there, they don't need us. We teach and they waste the time. If they don't need to change, nobody can change them. They must need to change, but they don't know how to change. We can teach them how to stop using chemical. We can teach the technique only. We cannot change their mind. We try to change their mind once 6 years ago. The project is the farmer free school. But our
farmer school, free school.
Yeah. But farmer free school is not like FAO, not the that curriculum. Our curriculum is primary school is how to control or manage the insect and disease. This is simple, very easy. The secondary school is the how to manage the soil. This is intermediate. The last one is high school or university is how to manage the seed. The last one is difficult. So we teach the farmer three steps, three seasons. And in the process, we use the, learning by doing, like a light, give the test to plot. This plot chemical that they use compared to our technique. And every week, we assign the homework that they investigate, observation and writing and drawing, everything to present to the group. One day in the week, you come together and present the homework. Like that, you go to the field to observation, what kind of the insect in your life field, what they do. Which one eat the rice, which one eat each other, like it, so they can present, you can know that, oh, the spider is good, it's not bad. So they learning by doing. So by this process, they learn each other, learning by doing, and use grouping, learn from each other, and can ask, criticize everything until they have the same answer together that, oh, it's true, we can pass to the next homework. So this, they can know the real thing, not by someone, by the real. And after that, they change their mind a little bit. And they can change the program after that. This take time and person to change their mind, but it's work, but not last long. After that, when we stop, when they listen to the advertising 1 or 2 years, they back again.
But how many people did you, how many farmers did you work with for that program?
Four place, 200 people. One class, we use 50, 200 of them. And when we finish, there only half left, about 100 left. 100 person stay until the last curriculum. And last 6 years, 100 person, I think about 20% left. That's still never changed.
They still go for the organic farm.
So only 10% from 200. From
dude, that's a good number.
Good number, but it's a take time and a lot of investment. It's not last long. So I think that waste of time. So we have limit time and person, so it's better to training the person who want to change easily. We can get more than 90% from this in 3 days, not 3 seasons. And so they pay for us. We don't pay anything, they pay for us. It's better. And we're waiting for the wind, it's better. When the wind comes, it's okay. Because we have many success stories all over Thailand already. Need to multiply only. So we have the seed that must sprout because they need the sun, they need the wind, they need the water. They need, but we have the seed everywhere, but not sprout. So that our policy that we training to make more seed and they will multiply in the future. We make more seed better. And only 3 days we can make more than 40 in 3 days. And that 3 seasons we can make only 20.
When you said 3 seasons, that means a whole year or?
Oh no, this they can grow two seasons per year, 1.5 years.
That one, 6 years ago, that
yeah,
was
yeah.
1.5 years.
Yeah. And you can get only 20%. Hard work, very hard. And we get award from this project, from the government. It's a, what you call, it's a research project that very, very best of the Thailand. Because the there are the organization named Research Supporting Fund. Research Supporting Fund. They give the fund to research all Thailand. But we don't take fund from this organization. But they receive the competition. They have competition every year for the award. The research project. So our project sent to that competition 1 year. The award they give no limit. They can give to every project that what you call reach the what you call it?
some standard.
Huh? Standard, yeah. The difficult. There are four item for them. So in that year there are more than 1,000 project sent to competition, more than 1,000, and only 18 get the award. 18 from 1,000, more than 1,000, less than 1%. Well, we get that because we are very successful. But we found that, no, we don't follow that because we have better way to make more seed that. But the wind is not fit. If the government adopt our technique, adopt our farmer physical, it will work. But no, they don't adopt at all.
So which year did you get the award?
9 years ago.
9 years.
Yeah, 9.
Again, this weekend. So in the could you tell us something about the preservation of seeds?
Oh, it's much long story. Rice is the origin here in Thailand and in the south of China. This is the origin of rice. So it's a long story, but in Thailand we eat the sticky rice in the past, and the common rice is around us. We adopt the common rice from India to Cambodia, from India to Cambodia and to Thailand. In the central plain, in the south, not the north and the northeast, still sticky rice. So we have variety of rice a lot in the past. Because they grow local variety that fit to the environment, and every farmer grow at least 2 or 3 variety, not one. So it means that hundreds of thousands variety in Thailand before Green Revolution. But after the Green Revolution come the irrigation area, they change to the new variety, the hygiene variety, that breed from the government, and they need a lot of chemical, and they can grow all year long. The old variety have the some constraint. The first, they are the rice sensitive. It means that they can grow once a year. They have flower in the short day only. It's like a, when September, October, November, they can have flower. Before that, none. You cannot grow outside the season. You can grow in the rainy season and harvest in the cool season only. Once a year. After that, no. The second, it's very tall. Very tall. So, it, before you harvest, it's flat to the land. It's easy to destroy. Because it's the stuck to the land. It's tall and falling down. So this is a weak point because when you use the machine, difficult to harvest them because it's very flat. And easy to mix with the mud and into the water, to the wind. It's not good at all. The third one is very low yield. It's not fit to the high yield. Even you put more fertilizer, more water, it's still the yield is the same. So from this they change to the high yield variety. Very short and can grow all year long. Can grow every time that you have water. And the yield is double or triple. This is the green revolution that happened. But you need irrigation. You need machine, you need the chemical. You need the external input. You need a market. But the government prepare for you. They prepare the dam, the irrigation, the machine, the officer, the bank, everything prepare for you for this. And when they're promoting everything very fast, in 5 years, Suphanburi changed the variety already when I graduate. In 10 years, the buffalo gone. Before that, buffalo everywhere. In 10 years after the new variety come, they destroy the buffalo gone. They use the tractor. Everything changed very fast. And the farmer joined the marketing economy, became one part of the economy. And they depend on the market. So before that, they go right for eating and keep for all year long. And when they need some extra money, they sell rice. Sometimes they sell rice. They have the rice like the bank for eat, for sharing, for the temple or for money. They save. But for the new variety, they can grow 2 or 3 times per year. They don't save anymore. When they harvest, they sell all the money. And they use the money to buy rice, to buy food, to buy everything. The money oriented. But in this system, they depend on the market that they cannot control. So easily that we can see that now the farmer depend on the market and the market control him, control them. We ask very simple question to the farmer. When you grow rice, what you do? I buy everything. I buy seed, I buy the fuel, I buy the machine, I buy the fertilizer, I buy the chemical, I buy everything before grow rice. And who put the price? Who can control the price? That how much the seed, how much how many baht per gallon of the fuel, how many baht per kilo of the fertilizer, who fix the price? He said the company fix the price. I cannot bargain I can pay what they said, because they fix the price for us. So it means that the price depends on them, on the market, not by us. So the first time. Second time, when they harvest the rice, they sell all the paddy to the market. Who fix the price? Because the first time, the seller fix the price. Now you the seller, you can fix the price. They said no. They fix the price. The buyer fix the price. Oh, so you lost again. Because who fix the price, who get the profit. So you cannot fix the price, even your product. Not enough. When you get the money, you have nothing, you have only money. When you want to buy food, you buy the rice from the market again in plastic bag. So when you buy the rice back to consume, who fix the price? The market again. Everything the market fix the price. So three times that you go to the market, you lost to the market all the time. So it's not like Taiwan or Japan or Korea that they have the cooperative that you buy from them. Cooperative depend on you, the profit give back to you. It's okay. Now the profit go to the company, not to you. So this system of marketing, you lost. Only way that you can survive is to you don't go to the market. So you don't lost to them. So how we can stop going to the market? You can save seed, you can save seed, you could not go to market, you don't pay to the market. You can make fertilizer, you can make your own herbal. Everything you can do yourself, you can save your money, not pay to the market that you can control them, not cooperative. The second, when you sell them, how you can sell yourself that you can fix price? If not, how you can less sell them? You have product 100%, 100 ton. How can you not sell all 100 ton? So if you save for some seed for the growing season, you can save seed, you not sell. Yeah? So this you not sell to the market. You don't lose to them. If you keep for your consumption, you not sell to them, you can save. You can sell only surplus, okay. It less. This the story that. So if you save for your consumption, you don't go to the market to buy the rice from the market again. So this the way that you can prevent the bad market, that you cannot control them. If you have the good cooperative market, okay, you can join them, but no, now we have none. With the first policy that stop, go to the market. The second, how to reduce the cost of production. Because when you sell, you cannot fix the price. The world market about 7,000 baht per ton now. You cannot increase them. Not the fake price like a government give us 15,000. 7,000 is the real. You can survive with the 7,000 how? So you can decrease from 8,000 now to be lower. If you low to 7,000, okay, better, but no profit. If 6,000, we have profit, but small. If 5,000, it's better. If 4,000, it's more better. If 3,000, oh, it's better. So the policy is to decrease the cost production as less as possible, but still keep the yield, it's high yield, the good quality, but low cost production. The technique must support this. Before we develop the technique, we know that we must do this, because this is the solution for our situation. Not look for the organic product, because organic, you must go to the, what you call, the situation market that difficult for the common farmer, difficult for them. Just decrease the crop production first and sell in the chemical price. Even we are not chemical, but we can sell in a chemical price, it's okay. We still have the more profit and we can survive in this situation. So last 19 years, our farmer very successful who follow us. They have many million baht. Even they sell in the cheap price because he invest very small and the yield is high and the labor is less. They use their own labor, not high any labor. Only the harvester only that impossible for him to harvest. The harvester only, the machine.
So are you saying that most farmers, rice farmers, they sell their rice and then they buy the rice back from the market?
99%, yeah. Because the first, they don't want to keep any rice to consume, because the first they must have the barn to stock like us, or the sack. The second, they must dry themselves, not fresh, you know. They sell the very moisture rice and they decrease the price. They must dry in the sun or something to keep. They don't want to that. And they must carry to the rice mill to milling to be there. They don't want to work at all. It's too much work for them. It's better to buy, you see, it's the first. The second, the variety of rice they grow is no taste. It's very bad. It's not for human. It's hygiene only, but no taste, no quality at all. So they don't want to eat that. Very, very hard, no taste at all. The third is very toxic because they know they use a lot of chemical. They know, so they don't want to eat their own product. It's very, very chemical. So they know.
But then the products they buy would be the same.
The same, but they don't know. They don't know. They don't see. So it's okay. They come in the plastic that very clean, very shiny, and then they come from the big company. They don't know. And the taste is better because they mix. They don't use pure. They mix with the some variety that they know. It's better. They put some smell, something. They have the trick that make the farmer accept, but maybe more chemical, because when they keep, they must use chemical to control the insect. So it's more dangerous than in the field. But the farmer don't care, they don't know. So why the farmer now became, a lot of them have the cancer, a lot. They leak from the field and from the food they buy from the market. Everywhere, they don't know why they have a lot of the cancer now. I asked the, we know when somebody die, they are the music from the temple, you see. I will ask the farmer how they die. It's cancer, it's diabetes or something, just common. Some they leak from the poison, some. It's common, but they don't do anything.
But you have been trying to save seeds.
Yeah.
Yes. So how many varieties?
So the seed is very complicated. The first, the local seed that's still growing, only in the rain-fed area. So rain-fed area is fit to the local one, because the rain-fed. Rain-fed area, it have the water only the rain season, and the local variety, it fit to the rainy season, and without chemical, because rain-fed area difficult to use the chemical, it cannot control the water, so the rain-fed area still growing the local variety, most in the north and northeast that sticky rice, not the commercial, not the business. If the sequoia is not in the world market, so if you want to collect the seed, the local seed from the government seed bank, that keep the local seed for about more than 10,000 variety. Oh no, 10,000 accession. 10,000 accession, the
samples.
Yeah, more than 10,000 samples of the local one. But the name is about 6,000 name, different name. So it means that some sample is the same variety but different sample only. From that, we can take back the local one and growing and taste them and select them until they show the, what you call, the character, what we need from them. This aroma, this disease resistant, this long grain, everything we study from this, and we win the rock first before we can use them, because this area is the irrigate area. They don't adopt the local one. They need the first non-sensitive to light. It means that you can grow all year round. They need that variety that can grow all year, not only the rainy season. So we will be breeding them to the new variety that fit the need. The second, they need the short, not the tall. We can breed and make it short. The third is high yield, not low yield. We will breeding to fit the need. This we must develop the old variety to this character. But we keep the quality of the rice, like aroma, or the long grain, or the delicious. We keep the old quality and non-chemical and fit to the element, fit to the soil. We can do both. We can make the new better than the old and better than the new. So we breeding and select for organic, for high yield, for the no external input, for the quality. Everything we must succeed before they adopt our variety. So after we success, still the farmer don't use our variety because it not fit to the chemical. They don't adopt because they must use chemical. So nobody use our variety that we breeding for more than 8 years before we success. We have more than 200 variety that we breeding. So last 2 years we have opportunity to promote, because the association of the rice mill, the rice mill association in Suphanburi, they have the idea that they will promote some quality of rice, especially for Suphanburi province, sufficient for Suphanburi province, so they can promoting for local consumption. So because they plan that in the future, when we have the AEC, the rice will come from everywhere. They cannot survive. They must have unique variety of the local area to promote. Because if you don't do like this, the big, more big company will take over all the rice mill, and they will bankrupt. So they need the survival in the future. So they have the plan that if they have the real variety that fit to the Suphanburi province, that fit to the farmer, fit to the consumer, and fit to the rice mill, and they will join together like a contract farming and all survive together in the changing world. They tried this for many years before they join us because they're not success. They said the consumer need the non-chemical rice that very delicious, but the variety that not local have none. Because the hygiene variety in this area, the first no delicious, no taste. The second, they need the chemical. The consumer deny, so they not success. So they approach us and ask us to use our quality to taste. So we taste with the farmer first that you grow with our technique. The yield is high and the cost is very low, quality is high. And after that, we taste with the consumer. They said, oh, it's a non-chemical and very good taste. They adopt, accept. And the rice mean, they taste, oh, it's a high quality to polish. They can get a lot of wage. So all of them select from 190 variety to be three variety that the last, the three variety select by all of them. Agree all, consumer agree and the farmer agree and the rice mill agree. And the three variety register in the name Khoan Suphan is a commission name. Khoan Suphan. Suphan is the name of the province.
Khoan Suphan province.
Khoan is spirit. Spirit of Suphanburi.
A spirit of
Suphanburi, yeah. Three variety. And this three variety, the rice mill ask the farmer grow for them and give price higher than government price. Government price is 15,000. So the rice mill give 16,000. So when the farmer grow for them, the farmer can get more profit because higher price and lower expense.
And organic?
Not 100% because in real organic you cannot use the herbicide. The farmer said we cannot really organic because you must transplanting that take time and money. If you direct seedling, you use the herbicide just not more than 7 days. The first 7 days only. After that, non-chemical. The customer said, okay, we accept. Less than 7 days, you use only herbicide. The first 7 days only. After that, no chemical fertilizer, no nothing. Just first 7 days. But you not that burn straw. You must leave the straw in the field because the straw can absorb the herbicide. So we proved that this technique, even the earthworm not die, it's okay, it's safe because the earthworm still survive. It's easy because if really organic, it must be more expensive. So they sell the retail price 55 baht. 55 baht per kilo to the consumer. If the organic is more than 100, I think it's too much for the consumer. This is the first year we start this for 1 year already, last year. The problem is the rice is sell to the consumer in the urban market, not in the rural. Because in the rural, the rice is very cheap because support by the government is about less than 30 baht per kilo. We have 55. They don't buy our rice. But the herbal people said, oh, it's cheap, 55 baht. They buy. But the herbal consumer said, it's not soft enough. They need soft like a jasmine rice. But our rice is not soft like that because the common people don't like too soft. Because when they eat, they don't eat the rice alone. They put the spicy wheat and mixing. So it's softer because it's wet. This the way they eat the Thai food. Not separate. Not like Chinese food that you eat rice and you eat this the soup or something, not mixed. In Thailand we put on the rice and mix first before we eat. So need more harder, not too soft. So the urban people eat Chinese food, most of them. They need more softer. So this is the problem that they said, we need more softer, not hard like this. So this is the problem that, so this second year, we select again to more softer. And now we get that already, the softer one, to fit to the urban. And this year we will multiply to that fixed group of the consumer for the soft consumer. And I think that next year when the government stops support the farmer in the fake price, the price come to 7,000. So we can buy from the farmer 8,000. So we can reduce the price of the rice from 55 baht to about 35 baht. I think the common people can accept our rice. Not urban person, but the rural can accept our rice. So it depends on the market. But we have already the variety that fit to the local need.
So for this project, how many tons do you produce? Last year, this five...
All depend on the rice mill.
Yeah.
Last year, about 100 tons. They test the market and they found that, oh no, the market is the limit because only urban person that buy, it's too hard for them. And they stop. This price is only for the urban person. And the urban, they don't like this kind. It's too hard for them. So they stop multiply this season. They're waiting for more softer already that we develop for them already. But when we develop, the seed is too small, about 20 kilograms. You must need 2 seasons to multiply to the market. This season, 20 kilograms to about 4 rice. From this, another 4 rice to 100 rice. So you can give to the rice mill after that. Not now. This is what you call? It's the start of the story. Because after we open the market next year, it might be harder. Because the rice from Cambodia, from Myanmar, that local variety, that good quality is coming and cheap. So we will adapt anymore, more to that. It's more difficult because they're cheap and good quality.
TV. Yeah. They have only one bed. Jenny was wanting to ask a question. I'm trying to see if they,
yeah.
Although we have very little time left, but then whether they have any questions.
What for shopping?
But then the seeds that you, how many, Well, you still produce, you still breed the 200 varieties of rice.
Yeah, we succeed already. So in breeding, when you breed 2 varieties, you must, what you call, have your plan that what you need for the yield or the short, need for the aroma and the quality of the seed. Everything you must know what you need and breed together. When you breed, you have only one seed. This seed, you must grow at least 8 seasons and select what you need from each season until it fit in the 8. From the 8th generation, it fit already. You must select until it fit. After this, you can multiply them because it fit, became the purebred already in the 8th generation, 8 times, 8 season. So from one cross, maybe you can get 50 or 100 of variety from only one cross. They are very not the same. The yield, the quality, the age, everything, they vary. When you select, you have the standard. This, if in this standard is okay, you can get not only one but many, maybe 100 of them. So from 10 of them, but you must have time to select them. You have must have the area to grow them. It's a hard work. So we continue to do this lot, and the second, the third, to improve more and more, to adapt to the environment that changed, to the global warming, to the flooding, to the consumer, to the disease, to the insect, everything. They must breeding for the future, not for today. Everything changed. You cannot stop. Even you have the best rice variety, but the next day maybe not fit anymore. So you breeding to the future for select in the future, not stop. So why we put the seed is the most difficult, because you cannot stop. Maybe your land you can improve 2 or 3 seasons is okay. You can continue, but the seed you cannot stop. You must develop all the time. And we keep the old variety to be the stock for the breeding, not direct using them. So we keep them, we keep here not too much, about 200 of them. We have no land and no labor to grow all of them, 10,000, no. 200 is enough to select to crossing. And we can take the new one and keep the old one, because we have limited land. If we grow this 200 this year, next year we can stop some and take the new one in this 200, because we can keep for 10 years at least in the refrigerator, the seeds. We can take back anytime. So this the technique that we cross and we test them and we select them, and after that we test with the farmer, with the consumer. It's all technique. Someone must do this. We train the farmer a lot to do like us, but nobody use because it's hard work. They know how to do, but it's hard work for them. So they just waiting for us. Easier.
How many of you are doing this?
We do this in certain plain. And in the north, I think there are 1 or 2. In the northeast, there are 1 or 2 our students that working. In the south, not yet. So we training a lot the breeder every year, but they still not practice because it's not breeding, but it's selection that take time. Eight season breeding, just one season, one month is okay breeding. 1 month you can get the seed, but from the seed, 8 season before you can stop, and must continue until you fix them. That very, very hard work. You cannot go in the pot, because one seed, you you, when you grow, you can get about 3,000 seeds from one seed that you breed. You can grow in a pot, and from the pot you can get 3,000 seeds from one seed. This F1. From F1, the seed became F2. F2, 3,000 seeds. You must grow all the 3,000, not only one, all of them, to select the character that you need from both. You must find out in 3,000. If you cannot find out, you're breeding the new one. You stop. You must find out in the 3,000. Which one it fit to your need? If none, you stop. You breeding again with the another variety. This variety it not work anymore. If you can find, you continue to F3, F4, F5, F6, F8 to fix that character until it finish. So it's big work. So why most of the people don't work this? Let the government do this work. So when we let them do, they fix everything. They fix the yield, they fix for the chemical, everything in the seed. So when we adopt the seed, we adopt the chemical. So it depends on them. So the seed change everything. What we do for the farmer is the, what you call, the easy way. Adopt the seed from the government and train the seed to fit to the organic. Like I teach you, open them like a brown rice and select the best brown rice, the most beautiful brown rice, and germinate them at least 100 seedling. In 100 seedling, you transplant one by one, 100 seedling in the field that no chemical, no spray, no fertilizer, only organic. And until you harvest, in 100 seedling, you select only 5% or 5 seedling that the best in your condition, in your land, in your season, in your soil, in your disease and your insect, everything. The best 5 only that adapt from the chemical to be non-chemical. So the first season maybe not so good, the best five is not so good. So from the first 5, you take the seed from the best one, open them again and select the best 100 again and transplant 100 seedling and select the best 5 from the 100. If not enough, yeah, you do again 3 season to train them 3 season, and in the 3 season you can get the adapt seed that 100 seed is the same, the best of them. You can stop after 100 of them is the same, not different. So this the way to train the chemical seed to be organic seed, not breeding. It takes only 3 seasons, not more than 3 seasons. It's easy. If you're breeding, it's 8 seasons. Maybe not get anything because it's not fixed together and need a lot of land. This only 100, small place. This 100 seedling, need a little bit. Anybody can do. This is the easy way, not breed, only select from the chemical one, or you can select from the local one. We found that in local one, some farmer can increase yield for 400% 4 times from 2.5 ton per hectare to 10 ton per hectare, the yield, the local one, local quality, the low yield. when they select this technique, they found that the yield increased from 2.5 ton to 10 ton per hectare. You can use both with the local one and the chemical seed. But the local one still sensitive to light and still tall. Only yield that increase. The technique is not complicated. The technique is simple, but depend on the local environment. We select in the specific environment, so it fit only your place only, not fit another place. This good for everybody, but everybody must do for themselves, not ask from anybody. This seed fit to me only, not fit to you. If you take from me, you must test again to your place, because it's specific, depend on the nature, not depend on the external input. It depend on the nature only, fit to the nature. But this technique is depend on the nature, not depend on the external input. So we try to do with the vegetable, but the next step. Vegetable is the next, because vegetable is many, many species, not rice. There are hundreds of them. Every species is different, and most of them come from outside, not local one. It's more difficult. And some vegetables have no seed here, it's too hot. Like a cabbage, no. We grow here in no seed. It's too hot. We must grow in the north, in the mountain, to have the seed. So it means that we must select the variety that fit to this. And when we found that variety fit to this area, we must send to the north to have seed. So it's more difficult, because we use the vegetable that not origin here. We live in the hot weather, but we eat the vegetable from the cold weather. It's difficult. If we eat moringa, it's easy. Amaranthus is easy. Even come from outside, but it's the same condition. Moringa come from India, it's okay. Most the plant in Thailand come from India, like a tamarind, like a mango, the jackfruit all come from India, it's no problem. This also moringa come from India. Amaranthus come from South America, it's the same tropical, it's okay, easy to grow. Like a corn, it's okay, can adapt easily. Not kale, not broccoli, not carrot, not different. We can grow, but it's difficult to improve them. It's too hot for them.